If you don't teach people and show them from scripture, God has nothing to work with. Because the word of God is the vehicle upon which God can work on the heart of men. Integrity is simply doing the right thing in the right way at the right time at all times. To succeed in ministry, I need the heart of a shepherd and the mind of a businessman, because ministry is business. How to build a strong itinerant ministry. How to build a strong itinerant ministry. Because one of the things we want to try to achieve through this leadership conference is called transformational leadership, because we want to use it to raise transformational leaders and equip transformational leaders. And that's why we have structured it in such a way that we'll be dealing with different aspects of ministry so that everyone can get something out of it. So you may be a pastor and you also want to go into itinerant ministry. You may not be a pastor, you may be a teacher and you want to go into itinerant ministry. This is for you. How do you build a strong itinerant ministry? I'm privileged of God to be a pastor and also one that has a strong itinerant ministry. And one of the things that God has helped me with is that He's given me multiple grace to operate in multiple platforms in different parts of the world. And I've seen from scripture that there is a provision for more of us to transform lives through this form of ministry. So we're going to start from Matthew chapter 4 and take our example from Jesus, our master. Matthew chapter 4 from verse 23. Matthew chapter 4 from verse 23. And Jesus went about all Galilee, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom and healing all manner of sickness and all manner of disease among the people. And his fame, somebody say fame, his fame went throughout all Syria. Now, please, he went where? All over Galilee. But where did his fame go to? All over Syria. Note those things. And they brought unto him all sick people that were taken with diverse diseases and torments, and those which were possessed with devils, and those which were lunatic, and those that had the palsy, and he healed them. And there followed him great multitude of people from Galilee and from Decapolis. Do you know what Decapolis means? Decapolis is 10 cities. So when they say from Decapolis, it's not one place that is called Decapolis. From Decapolis is a place with, it's like 10 cities combined. So when you say European Union, do you understand? When you say from European Union is not one country. It's a combination of over 20 countries. So when they say Decapolis, is a union of 10 cities. And from Jerusalem, and from Judea, and from beyond Jordan. Hello. So now, we're looking at how to build a strong itinerant ministry. Now, when you look at the ministry of Jesus, you will discover that Jesus, even though he was God in human form, did not come into this world and stay in Nazareth and die in Nazareth. He did not say, because God called me, I will sit down in one place. Because if you sit, you can stink. Jesus, even though he was God, had all the anointing. He carried himself and the grace of God upon his life, and he went from city to city, village to village, synagogue to synagogue, teaching, preaching, healing. It was after he has done this, he did it, that his fame now spread abroad. There are people that nobody will have ever known except because they went on TV. Many of you have never been to America before. You have never met all the American preachers, but you know them. When we say TDJs, Joel Austin say, I know TDJ. How you take know him? Which time you and I meet where you know him? But because they are on TV, because they have used the platform of the media to do what? To go from city to city, synagogue to synagogue. Then their fame has spread abroad. So that's the same thing Jesus did. Listen and listen well. We are hosting this conference, and we have great men that are coming, and there are people that are coming because of these great men. Hello? But when Pastor Matthew was in Foursquare Shomolu, you know him. When they sent him from Foursquare Shomolu to America to Pascal Foursquare, you know him. When he started KICC, you know him. But when he went to television, and we started saying, this man in Nigeria, you mean that Nigerian man, they do something for London? Before you know it, through the media, he started going from place to place. Now we all know him. Now he's coming. All of us are gathering. Hello? Papaya will be here on Wednesday night. Did you know him? But while he was with the Archbishop Benson in Daosa, they were doing crusades all over, villages all over, destroying devils, pulling down powers. When he left, he continued going around the world, organizing crusades. The blind see, the lame walk, the deaf hear. Posters all over, crusades all over. Then we all know him. Hour of Deliverance has been on for ages. And now he's the chairman of the Christian Association of Nigeria. Virtually everybody knows him one way or the other, even if you have never met him. And now he's coming, you are coming. When will people gather to hear you? Jesus went from city to city, village to village, synagogue. It was after his fame will not have spread. This is the same man that God said, this is my beloved son. In woman, well, please. Sorry, nobody heard it. Only those that were at the river heard. So God may have opened heaven over you in your bedroom and say, you are the one. The world is waiting. Now only you yell. The world that is waiting is not even aware you exist. So this is my beloved son, in whom I wear, please. That was River Jordan, though. While that was taking place in River Jordan, some people were somewhere in Nazareth doing their business. They know here. And there was no television to spread it. So Jesus had to go around in order for people to know, in order for his fame to spread. But you see, he went around, and then the Bible says from Syria, even to Decapolis, people started coming. Listening and listening well. If Jesus had not moved, there are many things that would probably not have happened. So it's very important for you to begin to consider this dimension of ministry as one of the instruments of impact in your own life. But there are questions we need to answer. Two questions. Question one, are you designed for an itinerant ministry? Because it's not everybody that can do itinerant ministry. It's not everybody who, because I know ministers of the gospel that hosting them by the sickness they carry, to host them, you'll be more concerned about them not dying while they are with you than the anointing they carry. I'm telling you a true life story. Ministers that if you put them in an hotel, they are asthmatic. If the rug is bringing dust, asthma will catch them before night. They're not going to preach. They don't eat onions, they don't eat pepper, they don't eat palm oil, they don't eat. So even the food you are going to cook for them, no hotel can provide it. You have to look for a special chef. Because going on itinerant ministry, they feel go die for somebody's church. Hello? Some people don't have the discipline of itinerant ministry. Hello? One of the things we do whenever people come to church to preach, sing, is after they have gone, we sit down and ask ourselves, was it worth it to bring this person? Did they really deliver? Did they do something? And that's one of the things we do. Yesterday night, on my way home, as we entered the car, so I asked my wife, how was church today? So we began to talk and analyze. And one of the things I told her yesterday, I said, as a minister of the gospel, I am very time conscious. Hello? So I told her, I said, there are two things so that you too will note it as a minister. I said, what do you think about that, our boy, the comedian? He said, oh, he did well. I said, he did very well. I was so proud of him. I said, but he did not keep to time. I said, I'm going to call him and tell him, I have plans to really push you. But if you are going to be so excited that you don't keep to time, you will not go far with me as a person. I said, do you notice that the lady that sang, 6 seconds to the end of her time, the microphone was back in the hand. I said, that was 100%. I said, that's it. I'm a time-conscious person. Hello? One of my mentors, Reverend George Adeboye, we call him the Moving Bible. Reverend George Adeboye is one of the few ministers in this country that God gave an opening into the white world to preach to white people. As a matter of fact, the first time he started traveling, he began to go to London. He went to a church called the Kensington Temple. And this was the church. Any pastor you know in London today, they all had a trace of Kensington Temple. They passed through Kensington Temple. But you know why they stopped inviting him? Reverend George can preach for 3 hours. In those days, he can preach for 3 hours. Hello? When Reverend George came to do my wedding, over 90% of the pastors that were there were telling me, Reverend George Luma, Naive Jilamaji. I said, no, it's not possible. I said, don't worry. I said, don't say that. When the man did everything and finished the wedding, all of them said, what did you do to Reverend George that made Reverend George to start and finish? I said, in fact, the way he handled everything was a champ, champ, champ. I said, no. Don't say. So you want to be an itinerant minister? These things are very important. So now the spirit is moving. They give you 1 hour, 2 hours. The spirit is still moving. So are you designed for itinerant ministry? Because some of you, your calling is church-based. Sit down with your member, just be a pastor and sit down there. Some of you, it's an outreach ministry. Some of you, it's an itinerant ministry. Some of you, it's a combination of us. So you need to answer that question. Because being an itinerant minister, there is money there. You will make money, but there is trouble there. Because when people think of itinerant ministry, the first thing they think is love offering. You know, they work like that. Before you even begin to collect serious love offering, you probably have done 10 to 15 years of itinerance.
Olumide Emmanuel, welcome you to Calvary Bible Church. Come for an impartation of wisdom every Sundays at 10 a.m. and every Wednesdays at 6 p.m. at end of Anjorin Street, Calvary Bus Stop, Idimu Ikotun Road, Idimu, Lagos.
It is happening in Calvary, church with the vision.
Calvary by the church.
Second question you need to answer is, do you really have something to offer? You say you want to be an itinerant minister. To go and preach what? That same 1 + 1 = 2 that you are preaching in your church? Is it that 1 + 1 = 2 you want to carry to the globe? Somebody, you mean somebody will pay you business class tickets? Pay for hotel for you to come and tell them 1 + 1 = 2 that they teach in the house fellowship? No. I'm telling you. So if you are going to be an itinerant minister, question one, are you called for it? Question two, do you really have something to offer? Because if you don't have anything to offer, they won't invite you back again. No? Hello? Because when I bring a guest minister here, it's not to entertain me or my people, it's to bless my people and add the dimension. So when the man comes and I'm like, even if I bring my evangelist or one of my association coordinator, they will download the same stuff. What's this man talking? Because it's not about what you say. It's also about this grace you carry. Even if you are saying 1 + 1 = 2, bring a dimension of the anointing that we had something to eat. You must have something to offer. And there are people that have climbed this altar. And in my head, I'm thinking, ah, well, this guy, the way is, well, I will invite him again. But by the time the guy finished talking, in fact, there is a man of God that came to this church. When he came, because me, I have some little things, you know, I'm not perfect. Me too, I get some virus in my head that I'm still clearing off some small. And one of the viruses is title. You see, I hate title. So when you start carrying bishop, you start carrying big title, I begin to wonder. Do you understand? I say, well, not this thing. But listen to me. There is a man of God. He's coming tonight and tomorrow. His name is Bishop Abraham Chibunu. This man is an apostle of deliverance. When this man stepped into this church 6 years ago, he's been coming every year. In fact, something shifted in the spirit. Then one day, one of the years, he came and said, ah, my brother, I'm becoming a bishop. Oh. He called for my dinner. I said, ah, bishop. I said, ah, how? He says, ah, car in my head. Listen, a true life story. I called my pastor. I said, this man has become a bishop. I said, no bishop has ever preached in this church before. I said, so we are inviting him. We have invited him before. He told me he's going to become a bishop. I said, when he comes to preach, that's the last time you people will see him here. No, true life story. I'm telling you, he's coming today to know that. So we settled it. I told them, because all these bishops say, how do you tell a bishop? Do you know the day the guy came, when we are supposed to say, after this one, he's not coming again. The first day, when he stood on the altar, he said, I hear a rumor from the Lord. No, as he was talking, within the first 3 minutes, my resident pastor is sitting down here. He turned to me and said, Pastor, Ali, stop mine. Ah! Ali, stop mine, yo. Mine, lano, it's in. Ah! Man, you more Bible. Ah, they stop man, yo. So listen, you must have something to offer. So I'll give you an example of somebody that we have said, but when the man comes, you will see him tonight. This one is not all this fake deliverance, just talking story, your father's side, your mother's side, agude, there's a demon again, the name of the demon is Taluta, the name, no. By the time Bishop Chibundu is through with scripture, by the time he pieces scripture for your head, your brain will open, your spirit will open. It's not so this funny people calling themselves deliverance minister. Hello? So did you get the two questions that you must answer? Number one. Number what? One, are you called for it? Number two, do you have something to offer? Nobody will pay you to come and make noise. Nobody will pay you to come and gist. You must offer something. Not that they've invited you as a guest speaker, and you come there and say, hallelujah, hallelujah. You know, I just bought a Mercedes Benz. You know, some pastor, and you're like, is this what really? So, you know, even my church, we just started 2 services. We invited you to come and bless us. You are telling us all that is happening in your own church, and that you just bought a car. In what way does that bless us? You know, I just came from London 2 days ago, and on my way to, I came here. From here, now I'm going to Italy because God is at work. And you're wondering, what's this man talking about? Hello? Have you ever seen anywhere in the ministry of Jesus where Jesus will go to a place and say, when I was in Nazareth, when I was in Galilee, somebody had the open blind eye open. Have you ever seen that? Jesus never referred to where he has been. Never. So what are the strategies you need to adopt to build a strong itinerary ministry? So now we are talking strategy, but it's based on the fact that those two questions has been answered. Strategy number one, let's go and let God. Psalm 127 says, except the Lord build the house, the labor in vain that build. Except the Lord watches over the city, the watchmen watch but in vain. So listen and listen well. There's something called the sovereignty of God. No strategy, no manipulation, no calculation can ever overrule the sovereignty of God. God can choose to lift a man. So even all the ones I'm telling you, you must have something to say. Even when a man has nothing to say, God can decide to lift him and let him be going all over the world saying nothing. And people will still love him because he is God. And nobody can question him. That's why he is God. So there is a sovereignty of God dimension. So, and let me tell you something about the sovereignty of God. You can't control his sovereignty. So all you need to do is let go and let God. Let God be God. Number two. Create opportunities. If you want to build a strong itinerary ministry, you must create opportunities for people to know you. In Luke chapter 4, verses 16 to 21, Jesus Christ said, "The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, for the Lord has anointed me." And he began to list out the dimensions of the anointing upon his life and ministry. And he said, "Today, this scripture is fulfilled in your ears." And from that day, people knew that this, there's somebody called Jesus. Please, please, and please, pastors, ministers, Christians, let us learn to be balanced. Many of us have remained local and obscure because we hear in our head, "Let the Lord announce you. Let the Lord announce you." There's nothing like that. Listen, Jesus was announced by God when he said, "This is my beloved son, in whom and well pleased." But plus the announcement, he went from place to place, village to place. So when God announced you, announce the announcement. Hello? So you must announce yourself. Publicize yourself. Matthew 4, 23 to 25. Jesus went from place to place. So you must publicize yourself. Go from place to place. Go from place to place. When I started out in ministry 23 years ago, I knew that God has called me to the body of Christ. And I started out being faithful within the context of where I was. And when I was in school, I was part of the drama group. And we're going from village to village doing what we call the village outreach. So weekend outreach that includes evangelism, miracle crusades, and drama. And when I came to Lagos and became part of a church, I started writing tracts, different Christian tracts, and the name of the ministry was Calvary Ministries. And then I had Olumide Emmanuel Ministries before we now got to where we are today. I was doing tracts, and I'll put do the tracts, "Where Thou, Consider Your Ways," you know, all those kinds of tracks. And then I have my P.O. box. Then there was no phone number then, you know, P.O. box and all the stuff. And people were inviting me just by reading tracks. So that was there. Then later I started a singles program called Gilgal Gathering. And the Gilgal Gathering, we used to go to the beach every Easter Monday from like 1992, 93, 94, 95. So we'll go to the beach, carry Moldo, carry youth all over Lagos, go to the beach every Easter Monday. That's part of announcing yourself. Do you understand? When I finally became the pastor of this church in 1995, by 1996, we started going from campus to campus in what we call Victory Seminar with Olumide Emmanuel. So Victory Seminar, I carried some of my guys, and we went to all the schools in Lagos State. All the universities and tertiary integrated college of education in Lagos. After we finished Lagos, we started going outside Lagos. Ado Ekiti, Ife, everywhere. We did that for many years. Later, when we used to do it, it was Victory Seminar. We'll go for 4 days and be teaching people all over. When that, by 1998, it metamorphosed and became Wisdom for Singles. And I began to do that. So by going around, people began to know there's somebody called Olumide Emmanuel. His church is Calvary Bible Church. He is in Idimu. So as people were finishing from school and coming back to Lagos, those living in the area say, "Ah, church, come on, man, come on, where's the school?" And that's it. So fame began to spread nationally. And also, so, and that's how it was going. So you don't just sit down. And then Wisdom for Singles, and then all kinds of stuff. And today, this is where we are. So listen and listen well. I did not sit down in Idimu wishing and hoping that God will just announce me. Many of us, we pray. But let me tell you something. It's not only by prayer. In ministry today, if you are not wise and strategic, you can die of frustration. So why do you need to go from place to place, announce yourself, and do all these things? Number one, to reveal your potential.
Olumide Emmanuel, welcome you to Calvary Bible Church. Come for an impartation of wisdom. Every Sundays at 10 a.m. and every Wednesdays at 6 p.m. at end of Anjorin Street, Calvary Bus Stop, Idimu Ikotun Road, Idimu, Lagos.
It is happening in Calvary, charged with a vision.
Calvary by the Church.
If you have been blessed with today's message and you want to accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, then repeat this after me. Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I believe you died and rose again for the remissions of my sins. With my heart, I believe unto righteousness. And with my mouth, confession is made unto salvation. Thank you for making me a new creation. I receive grace to walk in the path of righteousness. In Jesus' name, Amen.
I hear the sound of abundance of rain.
Thank you for watching. To order the complete message of this broadcast, please call the numbers on your screen.
Everybody.
Or visit our website, Facebook and Twitter account.